Hey y'all, I've been in Australia for about 3 years now, and I figured out a few things that I'd like to pass along. I compiled a list of things for Australians and Americans of what not to do when meeting each other for the first time. Okay, number one for you Aussies. When first meeting us, never just assume we are from Canada. That's like us just assuming you're from New Zealand. Same difference, right? Not at all. And as far as we're concerned, the only good things to come out of Canada are Mike Myers and hockey, and we only care about one of those things.
Swing.
Number two. When we say we're from America, never say, "Oh, I was in Canada last year." Okay, what's your point? Number three, a Yankee by definition is a native or inhabitant of a northern U.S. state, especially one that sided with the Union during the American Civil War. We're not all technically Yanks, just like you're not all banana benders or Queenslanders. I am, however, a Yankee, but that's not what we're talking about right now. Number four, before telling a redneck joke, ask what state we're from. Anybody that's from the Midwest or the South probably knows a lot of rednecks, is related to a lot of rednecks, or are a redneck themselves. So you might want to watch telling a joke right away. By the way, what do you get when you have 32 rednecks in one room? A full set
Okay,
of now
deep.
for you Americans. Number one, yes, we love the accent, but asking Australians to say something is not only vague, but really quite annoying. Number two for the Americans, unless you're a trained actor, married to an Australian for many years, or have lived in Australia for many years, never try to do your imitation of an Australian accent. You'll just end up sounding like an Englishman crossed with a redneck. Number three, under no circumstances should you ever ask an Australian to say, "Crikey, good day, mate," or "That's not a knife, this is a knife." You will honestly be the billionth person that thinks it's clever to ask them to say that. Number four, all questions about boomerangs, kangaroos, and Crocodile Dundee should be avoided at all costs. Australia really does have a lot more to offer. Get a book. And lastly, I would just like to say that Canada and New Zealand are beautiful places with great people. And any complaints should be emailed to playmealittlesong@tinyviolin.com. Bye.